Hang on a second. The tide hasn't come up to here. Shrine and a moon, maybe? That could be a whopper shot. So those two images you just saw, the Itsukushima Shrine at night and Mount Fuji sitting on a bed of clouds, I had actually taken those images at the end of 2022, which is over 2 years ago now, and I had them printed a few months after I came back. But I've only finally actually gotten around to framing those images and hanging them up on the wall. So let's go through it. Step one of making these prints, prepping the files. Once I had the image the way I liked it in Lightroom, I exported a full-size TIFF and then I imported that TIFF into Photoshop and used Photoshop for resizing and sharpening. So to resize the image in Photoshop, it was very straightforward. I just used the image size tool and I scaled it down to 24 inches by 8 inches at 300 pixels per inch. And then for sharpening, I used the Smart Sharpen filter. And I went fairly medium on the sharpening, so I cranked it up quite a bit, but I also made sure to keep the radius under control and make sure to sharpen as much as you can without getting any like weird halos in the image, because if you sharpen too much, you get that weird digital artifacting where you get like this white halo around some objects. I made sure to not get those, so essentially I went up until I was just about getting them and then backed off a good bit. So then with the image resized and sharpened, I exported the TIFF and sent it off to the lab for printing. Step two, getting the files printed. So to get the files printed, I went to a lab in Cork that does really good printing called The Bigger Picture. The reason I went there is because I know the guys that run it. They're heavily involved in the analog scene here in Ireland. So I headed down there for a day and picked up my prints. Now they can ship them to me, but I decided to make a day trip out of it and head down. However, all of the footage from that day got lost when I was cleaning out my hard drive. I must have just deleted it by accident. So here's Google Street View of what the shop looks like. Step three, doing a horrible job of the framing by myself. So it's time to actually attempt framing these prints. I've never done this before, so we'll see how it goes. But we have our prints here. I had these printed like over a year ago now. And these are from my 2022 Japan trip. These are not. This is the dummy pictures that come with the frames that I bought, which by the way are 8x23 inch frames. They are cheapo Amazon frames. So we have the Itsukushima at night print and of course the Mount Fuji print. So they're the two prints that are going into the frames, and this Taipei 101 shot is going to be a test print that I'm going to use to practice gluing these onto a backing. I'm gonna start laying down some paper. And we're ready with that. First thing we need to do is, I think, cut out a piece of card and have a go at spray adhesiving these down and seeing how that goes. This is just some A1 card. I had to buy A1 because, funny enough, the prints are 24 inches long and A2 card, which would be half this size, is exactly 23.6 inches, so slightly too small. No, I don't have an ironing board over there that I'm using as a table. Why would you even say that? I'm just gonna cut this across here roughly. I wanna give it a good bit of extra room to put the ruler down. Nothing bad has ever happened from winging it with glue in the past. Good layer. That might be a bit much on the glue front. Notice how I've turned it down a little bit. Okay, so I think that looks half decent as a print. Obviously not the picture, the picture is terrible. But I think that actually looks pretty good. Yeah, so let's try it with the Taiwan print. I know I should be handling this with gloves. I will be handling my actual prints with gloves. I have cotton ones. Remember, test print. In case you're wondering what paper this is on, it's on Hanamule Baryta. Oh, this is destroying the print, touching it like this, but seems to have adhered pretty decent. Seems to have adhered pretty decently as I go to peel it off and it's not stuck at all. Okay, that seems to actually be adhering pretty decently now. So let that dry for a bit and we'll come back in a few minutes and see how it adhered. So if we take a look at our print here, we can see it has turned out pretty decently. The edges are a little bit rough, but they're going to be hidden behind the border of the frame anyway on the actual prints. But everything else seems to have turned out pretty decently. Just to open it up. Just went for a nice white card. Probably doesn't really matter that I wear gloves or not, but I just want to good practice and all that. We're going to give it a good bit of space around so that I have somewhere to put the ruler when I'm cutting it out. I really shouldn't use a ruler like this. I should have a proper long ruler. I do have one somewhere, but you don't want to be like going along ruler, because you'd end up with a cumulative error as you move along. The Fukushima or the Itsukushima night print is the one that I'm actually interested in mounting properly, so I'll do that one last. Worst case scenario, I have to order some new prints. It'll suck, but that is it. Okay. Lay it down. So put this aside, well out of the way, in case of any glue overspray from the next one. Lay it down. I'm just gonna let that sit for a while. And we'll be back in 30 minutes or so once those have dried enough, and then we'll cut them out and get them in the frames. I am about to commit a sacrilegious act. So the photos are now glued down to their backing. They look pretty good overall. The glue dried well. Everything seems to be mounted well. And I'm just going to mount them straight onto the glass. I know you're not supposed to do this. I know you're supposed to use spacers, blah, de blah, de blah. Here's the thing, it's a borderless print. Making a space for this is going to be a goddamn nightmare. And I don't want to do that. So we're just going to drop the print in. Here's our backing board. Now I need to make sure it's the right way around. So the top is up here. So I need to put this in this way. You might ask, why did I bother gluing them down at all when I could have just put the print directly in? Originally I'd planned to put spacers in. I wanted it to be stiffer and all that, but hey, if I was going to get these done better, I'd have them professionally framed, or I'd use a service where you just get them printed and framed together. It'd be much easier. But this is just me trying to have some fun with framing and seeing how I can do it. Because I'm one of those people that really enjoys doing things my way. Or learning how to do things. There we go. Okay, we're in. There's even a weird color banding thing. I think I put too much glue on that one anyway, so like, that's just a demo. I actually have a brand new frame here. It's still in the plastic. That's for the good print. Looks pretty good. There's a slight pressure mark here. Where I made a bit of a mistake. What a shock. I was reading online, apparently some people like to cut them with a beveled edge by using the knife at an angle. I'm not doing that because the edge is going to be hidden behind the frame, so it wouldn't make any difference. Pop it in the frame and see what it looks like and see how bad it looks. Bend to a few of the tabs down. Let's take a look. Oh my God, there's a bit of there's a bit of crap in there. Right, I have to open this up and take that out. Lift you out nice and careful. Okay, where is that lump of crap? There it is. That should solve that problem. So pull it in this way. So top up here, tabs down again. There we go, that looks half decent. Even though there's an obvious smudge there. Yeah, it's just on the outside of the glass. That's that mounted. There's our two frames done. So there we go. Two panoramas framed. Okay. You know what? I think this calls for something special. Now that is satisfying, even though it's a small print and it's probably badly done and improperly framed and I made a big mess of it and it's upside down, inside out and backwards. Even still, seeing the print hanging on the wall like that, it's pretty damn satisfying. And I can look at it any time. No power needed, no screen, no weird color calibration, just there she is. Itsukushima at night. I'm pretty damn happy with that. And with that, I'll see you next time.